Hi everyone, in this video we're going to tackle ARIA. We'll cover the basics including what ARIA is, the number one rule of ARIA, and several examples that show the impact of using ARIA incorrectly. First, ARIA is HTML used to make web pages more accessible. Not all HTML elements have accessibility built into them, so ARIA is used to add that accessibility. Even though ARIA can make websites more accessible, the number one rule of ARIA is actually don't use ARIA. This rule just means if there's an HTML element that'll get you the behavior you're looking for, then use that HTML element. With that, let's get into the impact of using ARIA incorrectly. ARIA is often added to HTML haphazardly or left over after copying and pasting other code. But a common saying is, no ARIA is better than bad ARIA. We stress this so much because incorrect ARIA can actually cause big accessibility problems. So let's look at a few examples of incorrect ARIA to see exactly how it would impact someone using assistive technology. You'll notice with each of these examples that, visually, everything looks fine. So the issue would go overlooked unless the developer understands ARIA or someone does accessibility testing. Let's start with a button. A button submits a form, opens a modal, toggles an action, or resets information. Users who navigate with a keyboard expect a button to activate or be selected when they click Enter or Spacebar. Here's how an inaccessible button would work for someone using a keyboard and screen reader.
Print page button. You are currently on a button inside of a frame. To click this button, press Control Option Space. To exit this web area, press Control Option Shift Up Arrow.
You'll notice the screen reader said it was a button and depressed the voiceover key with spacebar to select it. It said this because of the ARIA HTML. But since it didn't have the JavaScript to make it function correctly, or it wasn't made with the HTML button element, I wasn't able to click spacebar or enter to select it, causing me to be stuck. The next example is about ARIA Expanded, which tells an assistive technology user if a navigation or accordion is collapsed or expanded. Here's an inaccessible use of ARIA Expanded.
Ingredients, expanded button. Ingredients, collapsed button.
The screen reader did announce when the element was collapsed or expanded, but the collapsed and expanded states were reversed. So the screen reader said the toggle was expanded when it was actually collapsed, and collapsed when it was actually expanded. If this opened a large menu, the user might have to use several keystrokes to now get through the menu when they thought it was collapsed. Or if they thought the toggle was expanded, they would continue thinking the content being read is what was in the toggle element when it wasn't. Our next example is with ARIA Label. ARIA Label renames an HTML element when it's announced by assistive technology. For example, if I have a nav HTML element, a screen reader might announce this as nav or navigation. If I use ARIA Label to rename it primary navigation, a screen reader would now announce primary navigation. Here's an example of ARIA Label used incorrectly in a form.
First name, edit text. Last name, edit text.
When I got to the email field, the screen reader incorrectly announced the field was last name. That's because that field had ARIA Label equals last name, and this overrides any HTML that says the field is for an email. An assistive technology user would enter their last name, which would completely break the interaction. Our last example is ARIA Hidden. When ARIA Hidden is used on an HTML element, it hides it from assistive technology. Here's how an incorrect use of ARIA Hidden can affect a screen reader user.
Entering content list. Link. FAQs. Leaving content list. Open section menu group. Entering content list. Link. FAQs. Leaving content list. Open section menu group.
Because ARIA Hidden was applied to the Apply Now button, the screen reader skipped right over it. Now that user isn't even getting that content, which obviously is a big problem. In these examples, we saw how incorrect ARIA can completely break an interaction for assistive technology users. We also saw that these broken interactions visually look correct, which is why they go unfixed. So always check the ARIA to make sure it's working as intended, and if you don't know what it does, remove or research it.